a quick review on use of water in dosage forms. This is an important topic not only for your licensing exams, but also for when you start your practice. Now, just so you know, this video is part one of a lesson covering pharmaceutical excipients. When the second video on pharmaceutical excipients is ready, you will see the link for that video here on the top, as well as down below in the description of the video. In this video, we will briefly review types or grades of water as defined by United States Pharmacopoeia that are commonly used in pharmaceutical processes as well as in preparation of dosage forms. We will also compare preparation and packaging requirements for these water. At the end of the video, we will also go over sample question to check your knowledge. So let's jump right in. United States Pharmacopoeia specifies uses, packaging, methods of preparation, and quality attributes of water that are commonly used for pharmaceutical purposes. These 9 types of water are also known as monographed waters. All other waters, such as drinking water or distilled water, fall under the category of non-monographed waters. Remember that all non-monographed waters are bulk waters that are typically used for manufacturing or analytical purposes. For those of you who are interested in knowing more about non-monographed waters, you can follow the link included in the description of this video. For this video, we will primarily focus on monographed waters. Based on the packaging, monographed waters can be of 2 general types. First one is bulk waters, that is those that are produced on site and are distributed from an internal water system. Second type is packaged water, that is those which are produced elsewhere and packaged for transportation. These are also sterilized to preserve microbial quality throughout the shelf life of the package. As shown in the figure, there are 4 types of bulk waters and 5 types of packaged waters. Here's an interesting fact. All packaged monographed waters are packaged form of either the purified water or water for injection that has been sterilized to preserve the microbiological properties. We will go over all these waters, beginning with purified water. The first kind of bulk water is purified water. It is prepared by treatment of a source water, such as drinking water or potable water. Depending on the need, typical treatment steps include combination of processes such as prefiltration, softening, dechlorination, deammonification, deionization, reverse osmosis, distillation, ultrafiltration, and UV light treatment. According to USP specifications, purified water cannot contain more than 10 parts per million of total solid, and the pH of purified water should be between 5 to 7. Now remember, it is a bulk product and is used as an excipient for production of non-parenterals as well as for cleaning of certain equipments. Purified water should not be used in parenteral or ophthalmic products. Next type of bulk water is water for injection. Water for injection is usually obtained by treatment of drinking water using superior treatment processes like distillation or reverse osmosis. Water for injection is also expected to meet bacterial endotoxin specifications. In simple words, it conforms to the standards of purified water and is also expected to be free of pyrogens. However, unlike purified water, water for injection is commonly used in the production of parenterals. The 2 other types of bulk water include pure steam and water for hemodialysis. Let's talk about pure steam first. Similar to purified water, pure steam is also prepared from pre-treated source of water such as drinking water. It is vaporized using a suitable mist elimination process and is distributed under pressure. Pure steam is primarily used in steam sterilization of equipments as well as in cleaning of official articles or containers. Regarding water for hemodialysis, this type of water is specifically used for hemodialysis applications, mainly the dilution of hemodialysis concentrate solutions. Like other bulk waters, it is also produced and used on site. As mentioned earlier, purified water and water for injection can be packaged and sterilized to form packaged waters. As shown on your screen, purified water serves as the source of sterile water for inhalation and sterile purified water, Similarly, water for injection can be used for manufacturing sterile water for irrigation and sterile water for injection. Let's go over these waters. As the name indicates, sterile water for inhalation is typically used in preparation of inhalation solutions. In general, sterile water for inhalation contains no antimicrobial agents, except when it is used in humidifiers or other similar devices where it is liable to contamination over a period of time. Sterile purified water is simply sterilized and packaged form of purified water. This water also does not contain any antimicrobial agents. As this water does not meet the pyrogen specification specified by the pharmacopoeia, it is not intended to be used in parenteral preparations. Now, let's discuss waters that are obtained from water for injection. First one is sterile water for irrigation. Sterile water for irrigation is often packaged in containers that are typically greater than 500 milliliters in size. It is commonly used when sterile water is required, but when the application does not have particulate matter specifications. This water is hypotonic and has low refractive index. Therefore, this water provides excellent visibility during endoscopic urological procedures. Now let's talk about sterile water for injection. Sterile water for injection is packaged in single-dose containers of type 1 or type 2 glass. The containers for sterile water for injection can vary in capacity, but they cannot exceed a capacity of 1 liter. Therefore, limitations of total solid depends on the size of container. This water is used for processing of sterile products that are intended to be used intravenously. It can also be used for compounding. Another kind of water that is related to sterile water for injection is bacteriostatic water for injection. Addition of one or more antimicrobials to sterile water for injection produces bacteriostatic water for injection. Similar to sterile water for injection, it is also packaged in containers of type 1 or type 2 glass, but the capacity of containers cannot exceed 30 milliliters. You should note that among all the monographed water grades that can be used for parenteral administration, only bacteriostatic water for injection contains antimicrobials. Another advantage of adding antimicrobials is that these waters are safe for multiple uses after a container has been opened. Therefore, the containers used for packaging of bacteriostatic waters are often multi-dose containers. In previous slides, we covered some facts and specifications that can be hard to remember over a period of long time. Therefore, I strongly recommend using these cheat sheets and the mind map a few days before your pharmacy or other licensing exam. Let's find out how much information you were able to retain through this particular question. You should pause the video now to review your choices. Note that the question is asking for water that is used in manufacturing, meaning you should recall a bulk water. Also, it should be okay for parenteral use. As you can see on the cheat sheet as well as the mind map, the only non-pyrogenic bulk water type is water for injection. Therefore, the correct answer is C. You can download these slides, cheat sheet, as well as the mind map by going to our website or at the link given below.